I make the connection, what I like to do is, double check that, yes, that it sits in there, that it's not going to be too big of a window or too small of a window, because then you would, this is your opportunity now to make sure.
Thank you so much.
Okay, what I'd like for you to do, to make sure this connection is really tight, is I like to pull really snug, wrap it one time immediately and swing it around. That way, there won't be any separation. And then I'd like for you to wrap to your next interval and take one more stitch. That way this stays snug, and then we're gonna put the bead on. So go ahead and wrap it to your next interval and take a stitch. Okay, go ahead and make a connection.
Did you see Pamela's with her fingers?
Do I do it this way or that way?
The way you have, you follow the path of the thread always this way. Go ahead and take a stitch. And Nolan, I know you wanted to see this. She's getting ready to attach the bead. Well, you have a lot of options on beads. You can always do a couple more little ones or something.
Stack them or whatever. That's what I'm assuming.
When you stack them really tall, sometimes they can squiggle. So just be aware of that. And if your bottom bead is a flatter one, rather than a squattier one, it gives more of a foundation for if you make a little stack. What you're going to do is find exactly where it goes, and once you find where it goes, this needle is going to go between these coils. It's not going to pierce any pine needles. It goes between the coils. So you decide exactly where it goes, and then you're just going to drape this down and go underneath, in between those
in
coils.
Between.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then bring your needle up through the window from behind.
I mean, the same color.
And make sure your bead is exactly where you want it and that your beading thread is sitting straight. And then you're going to go up through the bead.
Well, let me go up through the bead.
And then let's go ahead and have your needle come back here, because what you're doing having one thread on the back of one on the front, because when you when you position it exactly where you want, then you tie these together.
Okay. What happens is this side of